إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا من بعد. Once again, I welcome all of you. We continue tonight, inshallah ta'ala, a reading من شرح عقيدة السلف أصحاب الحديث لفضيلة الشيخ الوالد العلامة الدكتور صالح ربيع بن هادي المدخلي حفظه الله تعالى وغفر له ولوالديه وللمسلمين والمسلمات. باب الإيمان بالحوض والكوثر. In this chapter, in this book, عقيدة السلف أصحاب الحديث, the creed of السلف, the people of Hadith, of الإمام الصابوني رحمه الله, it is from the عقيدة to believe in the حوض, which is usually translated as a pool, and the Kawthar, which is a river. قال الإمام الصابوني رحمه الله ويؤمنون أي أهل السنة والجماعة ويؤمنون بالحوض والكوثر وإدخال فريق من الموحدين الجنة بغير حساب ومحاسبة فريق منهم حسابا يسيرا وإدخالهم الجنة بغير سوء يمسهم وعذاب يلحقهم وإدخال فريق من مذنبيهم النار ثم إعتاقهم وإخراجهم منها وإلحاقهم بإخوانهم الذين سبقوهم إليها ويعلمون حقا يقينا أي أهل السنة أصحاب الحديث ويعلمون حقا يقينا أن مذنب الموحدين لا يخلدون في النار ولا يتركون فيها أبدا فأما الكفار فإنهم يخلدون فيها ولا يخرجون منها أبدا ولا يستعتبون ولا يفتر عنهم وهم فيه مبلسون ولا يترك الله فيها من عصاة أهل الإيمان أحدا. Translation of this paragraph in this chapter. So they believe, meaning أهل السنة والجماعة أصحاب الحديث, they believe in the حوض and the كوثر. Also, they believe in the entering of a group of Ahlul Tawheed into paradise without account. There will also be a group from them who will have an easy reckoning without any harm befalling them or any punishment overtaking them. A group of them who had sinned will enter the fire. Then they will be freed and led out of it and joined up with their brothers who preceded them in entering paradise. They know also, Ahlul Hadith, they know with certainty and truth that the sinful from amongst Ahlul Hadith, Ahlul Tawheed, will not remain in the fire eternally and will not be left there forever. As for the believers, they shall abide. As for the unbelievers, they shall abide in hell forever and never come out of it, nor shall they ever be reprieved. Allah will never leave in the fire anyone who was disobedient from Ahlul Iman. الشرح. In the explanation, يقول الشيخ الوالد العلامة الدكتور ربيع بن هادي المدخلي حفظه الله تعالى ومتعه بالصحة والعافية وباقي إخوانه من علماء أهل السنة والجماعة, قال يتحدث المصنف في هذا الفصل عن الحوض والكوثر فيقول رحمه الله ويؤمنون بالحوض والكوثر. He says here المصنف, meaning الإمام الصابوني رحمه الله تعالى, in this chapter, he talks about the Haud and the Kawthar. He talks about the Haud and the Kawthar, and he says that Ahlul Sunnah, Ashab al-Hadith, they believe in the Haud and the Kawthar. قال والكوثر نهر أعطاه الله محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم في الجنة. He says, as for the Kawthar is a river that Allah gave to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and it's in the Jannah. He's in the Jannah. وعلاقته أي علاقة الكوثر هذا النهر وعلاقته بالحوض أنه يصب منه ميزابان يغتان في الحوض يمدانه بالماء. So the connection that is between the Haud and the Kawthar is that there is two streams that come from the Kawthar and brings water into the Haud, constantly providing the Haud with water. وماء الحوض هذا وصف في الأحاديث الصحيحة أنه أشد بياضا من اللبن وأحلى من العسل وريحه أطيب من ريح المسك, وهذا للمؤمنين من هذه الأمة كما ورد في صحيح البخاري وصحيح مسلم. He says, as for the water in the Haud, which is mainly translated as a pool, but not to confuse it with the swimming pools these days. This is a pool, which is a Haud. He says, as for its water, as it is mentioned in the sound narrations, like in Sahih al-Bukhari and in Sahih Muslim, Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith number 6579, and in Sahih Muslim, couple of narrations, 2292, 2300, 2301. He says that this water, it is whiter than milk, and sweeter than honey, and its smell is better than the smell of musk. And this Haud is for the believers amongst this ummah. جعل الله وإياكم ممن يشرب منه. Allah make us and you from those who will drink from it. Amen. وذكر صلى الله عليه وسلم في أحاديث أن أناسا يذادون عن الشرب من هذا الحوض, فيقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنهم من أصحابي أو من أمتي. قال الشيخ اختلفت الروايات, فيقال له إنك لا تدري ما أحدث بعدك, فيقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سحقا سحقا, كما في حديث في البخاري كذلك وفي صحيح مسلم. So also there is other narrations that are in صحيح البخاري and also in صحيح مسلم. Certain people, they will come to drink from the Haud on Yawm al-Qiyamah, they will be pushed away from it, not allowed to drink from it, and pushed away. But the Messenger of Allah, he says, they are my companions. In another narration, he says, they are from my ummah. They are from my ummah. The Shaykh says, we have different narrations, but it will be said, you do not know what they have invented after you, meaning innovations. You don't know what these people have innovated after you, meaning they brought innovations, وَلَيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, into the deen of Allah. So then the Prophet ﷺ will say, سُحْقًا سُحْقًا, far away, far away. قال وهذه الأحاديث الواردة في الذين يطردون عن الحوض يحملها الروافد الخبثاء, الشيعة الروافد الخبثاء على أصحاب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, قبح الله الروافد وأخزاهم. آمين. He said, and these narrations that is about these people who on Yawm al-Qiyamah they will pushed away and not allowed to drink from the Haud. He says the Rawafid, these filthy Rawafid, the Shia Rawafid, they say that this ahadith applies to the companions of the Messenger of Allah. No. So they're the one that's going to be pushed away. And the Prophet said, far away, far away. Liyadu billah. May Allah disgrace them. Sheikh, he says, يحملون مثل هذه الأحاديث على أفضل خلق الله بعد الأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام. He says, they apply this narration, the Rawafid, the Shia, look at their filthy creed and aqidah. They apply these narrations on the best of the creation of Allah after the prophets and the messengers, عليهم الصلاة والسلام. Remember in chapters about the Sahaba, they are the best, not just the best in this ummah, but they are the best of any nation after the prophets and the messengers alayhimu salatu wasalam. قال الشيخ وإنما هذه الأحاديث في قوم ارتدوا وهؤلاء ليسوا بصحابة لهذا قال إنك لا تدري ما أحدثوا بعدك والصحابة ما أحدثوا بعد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم شيئا بل نشروا دينه وبلغوا رسالته على وجهها رضي الله عنهم. The Shaykh said, this ahadith applies on those people who apostated and left Islam. And they are not companions. Those who left Islam and die upon that, they are not companions. They are not companions. So that's why it was said to the Messenger of Allah, you do not know what they have invented after you. The Shaykh says, but as for the Sahaba, Shaykh Rabi' Hawatari said, as for the companions of the Messenger of Allah, they did not invent anything to the Deen of Allah. They didn't introduce any innovations to the Deen of Allah after the Messenger of Allah, nothing. Rather, Sahaba, they disseminate the religion of Islam and they convey the message of the Messenger of Allah as it is. They disseminate the deen of Allah, they spread it, they taught the people, and they convey the message of the Messenger of Allah وسلم, as it was, as they learned it from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. بِدِقَّة سبحان الله حتى أنك تجد بعد الصحابة يذكر شيء ويقول لعله كذا شك الراوي. Even the Sahaba, when you find in some narrations, you find the companion, he gives the narration, he says, وَأَظُنُّهُ كَذَا قَالَ كَذَا. And I thought he said this. I thought it was the third time or the fourth time. Precision. They have precision, رضي الله عنهم. So the Sahaba, رضوان الله عليهم, they didn't innovate. But the Rawafid, العياذ بالله, they mentioned that, they said that the Sahaba, they changed everything after the death of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Especially Abu Bakr and Umar radiyallahu anhuma wal'iyadu billah. And they do this because, so now if the people believe in their trick, their filthy trick, then they're not going to follow this deen that came to us through the companions. So what they turn to? To their version wal'iyadu billah. ثم قال الشيخ ربيع حفظه الله ويحمل هذا الحديث أيضا على أهل البدع وعلى رأسهم الروافد لأنهم أحدثوا بدين الله عز وجل أحدثوا أشياء كثيرة جدا. He says rather this hadith is applied on the people of innovation, and he said of course the Rawafid they are right on top of the list. They top the list because they're the one that have invented things and introduced innovations and matters that are not from the deen of Allah. They have introduced many innovations. منها تعطيل صفات الله عز وجل. عود الروافد, this Rawafid, filthy Rawafid, that they apply this ahadith on the best of the people after the prophets, عليهم الصلاة والسلام, they have invented many things in the deen of Allah, وليعذ بالله. Such as they deny the attributes of Allah. They deny the attributes of Allah. ومنها الوقوع في الشرك من دعاء غير الله والاستغاثة بغير الله والذبح لغير الله والنذر لغير الله. لأنهم يستغيثون بعلي وبالحسين وبغيرهم. Likewise, they fall into shirk, والعياذ بالله, the Rawafid, because they call upon other than Allah. They invoke other than Allah. نعم, they call upon Ali. أو علي والعياذ بالله. They call upon Hussein. Of course, Ali is one of the great companions. Hussein as well. He's the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We love them, we respect them, but we don't call upon them. It's not permissible in Islam to say, "Oh Ali, give me, help me, take me out of this. Oh Hussein, help me out, give me this." That's shirk akbar. Sheikh bin Baz rahimahu ta'ala, he says, هذا شرك أكبر مخرج من الملة والعياذ بالله. This is a major shirk. نعم, this is major shirk that takes out of Islam والعياذ بالله. لا تدعو لا ملكا ولا نبيا ولا صالحا ولا حجرا ولا شجرا ولا أي شيء, إنما تدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى. The one who is upon correct عقيدة does not invoke nor call upon anyone, whether it be an angel, be a prophet or a messenger, a righteous person, or trees or jinn. The one who is a Muslim upon the Tawheed, he call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, invoke Allah, yad'u Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, if they seek refuge with other than Allah, they slaughter for other than Allah, and this is a major shirk. Those who slaughter for some wali, subhanallah, jahl. People, they are upon ignorance and upon falsehood. You find in some Muslim countries, there are people, they pray, they make salat and say, La ilaha illallah. They don't know what he mean. And they steal when somebody is sick, or somebody doesn't have boys, have only girls, or somebody have only boys, they want one girl. Instead to ask Allah, somebody tell them, no, go to that grave, this tomb of this wali salih, even if that person is wali salih, even if he's a prophet. But see them, the ignorance of the aqidah. That's why the aqidah is very important. Because a person may fall into one of the things that nullifies one's Islam. Ayna'am, ash-shirku billah. This is the greatest of all of those things that nullifies Islam, al-iyadu billah. So it takes of one person to tell them, oh, your son still sick like that? Take him to this sheikh. Where he at? You think sheikh is going to do ruqya or something? Because ruqya is permissible. No, ruqya is shar'iyya, is permissible. No, take him to a sheikh. Where he at? He's dead. A dead person can help somebody? And then when they go there, they find wicked people in there. They're making it a business. They make it a business. All right, they're like, what are you here for? They have a price for every illness. They're like, well, they're here because we don't know what's wrong with them. Oh, he's going to take a lot to find out. So come on Thursday, come on Sunday, come two Thursdays after that, and bring this and bring that. And they start them with bringing a goat. Then after that, bring a cow. Then bring two camels. And money. Naam. And then they tell them, look, the sheikh says that the only way he's going to help you, he's going to slaughter a big cow. And they bring a cow and slaughter it. And unfortunately, subhanAllah, a lot of things. And then those wicked people who are there, They sell that cow to some butchers who for less money, and those butchers feed the Muslims haram meat. Because it's not permissible to eat from those things. Actually, there is juhal people who do not slaughter anything. They just wait in the area when somebody slaughters something, and then they go there and take meat from it. And they thought that meat is the best meat. Because it was slaughtered for this sheikh. Or rather, that meat is haram to eat from al-Iyadu. It's haram. That's why learning the aqidah, ikhwan, is very important for us to save ourselves and also for us to be able to help others. especially those amongst us who they may come from an environment or areas or countries where this some people may still practice in this. So we have to learn and convey the message, insha'Allah ta'ala. Naam, these are from the things and the mukhalafat of Ahlul Bid'ah. النذر لغير الله وغير ذلك من العبادات التي صرفوا كثيرا منها لغير الله. It's only a few of many of acts of worship that they devoted for other than Allah سبحانه وتعالى. لأن الدعاء عبادة. الاستغاثة كذلك. الذبح عبادة. النذر. These are acts of worship. دعاء is an act of worship. And he has to be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, istighatha, nadhar, al-dhabh, is from Allah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La yudhbahu taqarruban lil jinn, wala li wali. Hada shirk akbar. Walakin, idha dhabaha lil ta'am, lil akil, mathalan, hada jaiz. Aw dhabaha li yabi'ahu lil nas, kal jazzar. Hada jaiz. Amma annahu yudhbahu. تقربا للجن أو تقربا للولي هذا من الشرك الأكبر والعياذ بالله. So Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen رحمه الله تعالى, when he talks about the dhabh, he gave some benefits. He says also dhabh, slaughtering and killing animals, it is permissible in certain cases, such as a person slaughter some animals to eat for food, he wants the meat, that's permissible. Likewise, someone that's his business, he's a butcher, he slaughters animals and sell the meat, that's permissible. But these people, what they do? They slaughter animals to get closer to the jinn. Like certain people, what they do? Before they move to a house, before they enter into the house, they slaughter an animal, whether a goat, and a lot of time they say they have to be black too. With the jinn, they're like a black. How did they know the jinn like goat? These people, subhanAllah, how they know? Jahl, because the shirk transmitted from one another to another, and that's what they do. They do not go to that house until they slaughter that goat or that cow, whatever it is, for the jinn, wa'iyadu billah. And that's an act of shirk. Shirk akbar, wa'iyadu billah. قال الشيخ ربيع حفظه الله وكثير من هؤلاء الغلاة في البدع يعتقدون في الأولياء أنهم يعلمون الغيب ويتصرفون في الكون كالروافض العياذ بالله لأنهم يغلون في أئمتهم العياذ بالله شرك صريح يعلمون الغيب وكذا ولا شيء يقع في الوجود إلا بمعرفتهم وبإذنهم هذا الروافض الخبثاء. The Sheikh says, and many from this extreme, those extremists amongst the people of Bid'ah, because Bid'ah are levels, okay? There are those extreme innovators who they have aqidah. Their aqidah is to believe, that's in their aqidah, to believe that the awliya, the righteous people, they know the unseen. And they run the universe. Like the Rawafid, their aqidah, the Imam Ithna Ashari, they believe their aqidah, and that's in their books, by the way. It's not like something hidden. That's in their books, that their aqidah. Like we're studying the aqidah of the Salaf, the aqidah of the Rawafid, is this, that they believe that their imams, okay, they know the unseen, and nothing happened in the universe without their permission. Wal-iyadu billah. So Allah as-salamu al-afiyah. ومنهم من يقول بوحدة الوجود. There are those who look, the people of bid'ah, they are on different levels. إن هناك بدع في العقيدة والعياذ بالله. Innovations in belief and creed. And this is the worst one. And there is innovations in عبادات. People who add du'a in here or something like this, or they make dua collectively when they shouldn't and the like. But this is innovations in aqidah, in the creed, وَالْعَيْدُ بِاللَّهِ فِي الْاَعْتِقَادِ. They believe and they say بِوَحْدَةِ الْوُجُودِ. that A'udhu Billah, Allah is everything and everything is Allah. You see? A'udhu Billah. So Allah as-salamu al-afiyah. ومنهم من يقول بوحدة الأديان وحرة الأديان وما شكل ذلك. Other innovators, their aqidah and belief that all the religions are in the same now. All. And the freedom of religion, meaning choose, you want to be Muslim or Christian or Jew, it doesn't matter, it's all the same. It's not the same. Allah does not accept anything but Islam. إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ Whoever chose to be in a religion other than Islam will never be accepted from such a person and in the hereafter will be amongst the losers. But then they say, no, anybody can, so okay, Jews, they go to the Jannah, Christians go to Jannah, they just have to be nice, don't steal, alright, be nice. But what about shirk that they are upon? Say Allah is one of three. Huh? And those who say Uzair is the son of Allah, the Jews, they killed prophets, they denied the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said, there is not a Jew or a Christian who heard of me and the message I was sent with and don't believe in it except that he be from the people of the hellfire. You see? Now there is other people, they say they're Muslims, but they say, no. A Jew, Christian, Muslims is all the same. That's not the same, man. Is the haqq mitl batil? The truth is not falsehood together. Hey, na'am. قال فهؤلاء أحدثوا أحداثا خطيرة جدا بدعا خطيرة جدا في دين الله فيتناولهم عز وجل فيتناولهم الحديث كما قرره بعض العلماء وعموم الحديث يدل على هذا. He says, so these people, they have introduced very dangerous innovations into the deen of Allah, العياذ بالله. So they are included in this hadith as some of the ulama mentioned. And the general meaning of the hadith point to that matter as well. So the Shaykh is bringing another group of people. قال وهناك أناس ينكرون الحوض كما يقول الحافظ ابن حجر رحمه الله وهم الخوارج وبعض المعتزلة وهم الخوارج وبعض المعتزلة. Now there are certain people, they say there is no such thing as حوض. No, it's not our thing. There's no pool on Yawm al-Qiyamah, nothing. This hawd doesn't exist. As Ibn al-Hafidh ibn Hajar al-Asqalani in Fath al-Bari, volume 11, page 518, he mentioned, rahimahullah, these people who deny the hawd, they said there is no such thing. Walayyadu billah. It's not real. Such as the Khawarij, and some of the Mu'tazila. قال فحري بهؤلاء أن يحرموا وأن يطردوا من الشرب من هذا الحوض الذي كانوا لا يؤمنون به لأن حديث الحوض متواترة وقد بلغ عدد رواتها حوالي 80 منها في الصحيحين حوالي 20 حديثا عن 20 صحابيا وبقيتها في باقي دواوين السنة. The Sheikh says, so these people, they deserve to be kicked away and pushed away from the Hawd, since they didn't believe in it in this life. He says, they deny it, and the ahadith are many. Many are the narrations. The Sheikh Hafidahullah, he says, the narrators, they were like some 80 narrators who narrate this ahadith. In Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, there is 20 of them, 20 hadith. From 20 companions, of the companions of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the rest of those narrations, they are in the books of Sunnah. They are the books of the Sunnah. فيتجرأ أهل الضلال فينكرون الحوض بعضهم جهلا منهم لأنهم لا عناية لهم بالسنة وبعضهم كبرا وعنادا يعتقد عقيدة فاسدة فإذا وصلته الأدلة الصحيحة على فساد عقيدته والدالة على نقيض ما يعتقد يعاند ويكابر كما هو شأن أهل البدع في كثير من القضايا. The Sheikh says, so the people of misguidance and dalal and falsehood, they have this boldness, they're so bold that to deny the haud. After, with all of these narrations, sound narrations, still certain people say there is no such thing as haud. He said some of them, they do this out of ignorance. Why? Because they don't know what the sunnah is. They don't pay attention to the sunnah. They don't study the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. That's why they say there is no such thing, because they don't know these narrations. While others, they know the narrations, but they reject them out of arrogance and pride. Why? The Sheikh says, because these people, they already have a aqidah. They already have a belief that there is no such thing, the haud. So when somebody comes to them, what do you mean? No haud. What about the hadith? They're like, look, they find a way to reject, find one way or the other to reject those narrations, wal-iyadu billah, out of arrogance. As he said, this is the case of many people of innovation in many matters. Earlier, before I came here, I was reading from Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala. I was actually listening to him, listening to one of the talks of Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, and he mentioned something like this, similar. He was advising the people that they have to study the dalil, the adilla in a matter, didn't believe in it to be true and in reality. He says, do not believe in something and make it your aqidah. And then, when the adilla come to you, the Sheikh, he says, they try to accommodate this adilla according to the words already they believe in. That's why Ahlul Bidah, the people of Bidah and innovation, they sit together, agree on a matter. And then when somebody comes to them and says, but what you agreed on, that go against the hadith, they're like, no, it does not. Because that hadith doesn't apply here, and they start playing games here and there and take you to the right, to the left, around. That's why Shaykh al-Uthaymeen make a beautiful statement. He says, استدل ثم اعتقد. لا تعتقد ثم تستدل فتضل. استدل ثم اعتقد. Study. You want to, before you believe in anything, study the proofs. From Quran and Sunnah. لأن العقيدة من أين تأخذ العقيدة يا أخوان؟ Remember in the class of Saturdays, Sheikh Abdul Muhsin, the class that we're doing with Sheikh Abdul Muhsin Al-Badr, where the aqidah is to be taken, the creed of the Muslim, Naam Muhammad, Quran and Sunnah. وما هو الضابط في فهم هذه النصوص? And what is the criterion to understand this text of Quran and Sunnah? As-Sahaba, As-Salaf As-Salih. It's very important when it comes to the creed, to the aqidah, the Muslim should remember that the aqidah is to be taken from the Quran and the Sunnah. And how to understand this text of Quran and Sunnah according to the understanding of As-Salaf As-Salih, who are the Sahaba in the first place. And those a'imma of guidance who follow them on their path, like the Tabi'een, Utba' Tabi'een, and the great Imams. Why? The Shaykh Abdul Muhsin, he mentioned one thing. Why the aqidah has to be taken from Quran and Sunnah? Who remember? Why? Why there is no room for intellect and opinions? نعم. أحسنت. لأنها تعنى بمسائل الغيب. Because it deals with matters of the unseen. And there is no way for anyone to know anything about the unseen except through revelation. من يعلم الغيب? لا يعلم الغيب إلا الله. No one knows the unseen except Allah. So all of these things that we know about Jannah and hellfire, punishment, the bliss and the good things, the mizan. Anyone, does anybody here seen the mizan, sirata, the bridge? No. How do we know these things? Through revelation. Quran and the Sunnah. But does anyone say, oh, that mizan is like this, or the bridge is like this? No, we do it the way of the Sahaba, As-Salaf As-Salih, Ridwanullahi, alayhim. That's why the Shaykh says, استدل ثم اعتقد. Study. From أهل العلم, from the علماء الربانيون, الناصحون, المخلصون. Study the matter with its proofs, then believe in it. This is what your aqidah, because it's based on قال الله, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, بفهمي السلف الصالح. Anyone that try to bring you something else, you're like, listen, I cannot leave. I cannot adopt your statements while they contradict statements of Allah. Statements of His Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, would they understand? Some people, they may bring you, oh yeah, you're from those people. Okay, well, here is an ayah, here is a hadith. But then, oh, wait a minute, what understand? It's not the understanding of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Okay, I cannot just take an ayah and hadith according to your understanding. You see? So the Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen, he says, لا تعتقد ثم تستدل فتضل. Don't believe in something to be your aqidah and then try to find some proofs to support it. You'll be misguided. Aynan. قال فهؤلاء أهل البدع ينكرون حقائق يا إخوان بأدلتها لأنهم يكابرون ويعاندون والعياذ بالله لأنهم قرروا لأنفسهم عقيدة فلا يخالفونها حتى ولو جاء الدليل لا يخالفون والعياذ بالله. The people of innovation, whoever introduced them to that and establish for them that wicked creed and manhaj, let's say they believe in these matters, all these points. And if someone brings them a proof that opposes what they are upon, they don't take it. They reject the proof, وَالْعِيَادِ بِاللَّهِ. Why? Because they already believe in something. They said, look, this is how they do things. Rather, the Muslim, alhamdulillah, he believes in what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam left for us. قال أما أهل السنة فيؤمنون بالحوض ويؤمنون بالشفاعة ويؤمنون بهذه الأمور التي لا يعترف بها كثير من أهل الضلال والعياذ بالله كالمعتزلة والخوارج وغيرهم من أهل الضلال. He says, but والحمد لله أهل السنة, those who adhere to the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they believe in the حوض, they believe in the شفاعة that we, الحمد لله, we learned in the previous chapter, the intercession, the شفاعة. And they believe in all of those matters that is in the sunnah that many sects of dalal and misguidance do not believe in these matters, وَالْعِيَادِ بِاللَّهِ. Such the Mu'tazila and the Khawarij, they deny many things, وَالْعِيَادِ بِاللَّهِ. And other than them, from the people who are upon falsehood and upon misguidance. وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْكَوْثَرِ. نعم, أهل السنة والجماعة يؤمنون بالكوثر. They believe in the كوثر. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. سورة الكوثر. We have a surah, سورة الكوثر, عباد الله. He says, likewise, Ahlul Sunnah al-Jama'ah, they believe in the Kawthar. They believe in it. And we have a surah, Surah al-Kawthar. Verily, we have granted you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Kawthar. Therefore, turn in prayer to your Lord and sacrifice to Him only. For he who hates you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will be cut off from posterity and every good things in this world and in the hereafter. Now, ثم قال الشيخ حفظه الله مرة أغفى الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم إغفاءة ثم رفع رأسه مبتسما فسألوه لماذا ضحكت يا رسول الله قال إن الله أنزل علي سورة عظيمة ثم قرأ عليهم هذه السورة بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. ثم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم هل تدرون ما الكوثر قالوا الله ورسوله أعلم قال هو نهر أعطانيه ربي عز وجل في الجنة عليه خير كثير ترد عليه أمتي يوم القيامة، آنيته عدد الكواكب يختلج العبد منهم، فأقول يا رب إنه من أمتي، فيقال إنك لا تدري ما أحدث بعدك. وفسر ابن عباس الكوثر بالخير الكثير كما في صحيح البخاري في كتاب الرقاء باب في الحوض. The Sheikh mentioned that once the Prophet, the reason of the revelation of this surah, Surah Al-Kawthar, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم أغفى إغفاءة. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he didn't fall asleep, but like we say, if you're not asleep totally, you doze off or something? Dozed like this. And then a person woke up again. And then, but the Prophet ﷺ, he was smiling. And when he was asked why he was smiling, the Prophet ﷺ, he says, indeed Allah has revealed on me a great chapter. And then he recited to them this Surah Al-Kawthar. Surah Al-Kawthar. إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرْ فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ إِنَّ شَانِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرْ. And then the Prophet ﷺ, he said to them, do you know what is the Kawthar? Do you know what the Kawthar is? They say Allah and His Messenger ﷺ know best. He said, it is a river that my Lord has given me in the Jannah. And it is in the Jannah. There's a lot of good in it. My Ummah, those who believed in the Prophet ﷺ, they will come to drink from it on Yawm al-Qiyamah. He says what do you call it? The cups, the cups, they are so many, like the number of the stars. But certain people, they will be kept away. They cannot drink from it. They will be chased away from it. So I say, oh my Lord, they are from my Ummah. And it will be said to him, إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحْدَثُ بَعْدَ. You don't know what they have invented after you. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. وَفَسَّرَ ابْنُ عَبَّاسَ الْكَوْثَرَ بِالْخَيْرِ الْكَثِيرِ. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he explained Al-Kawthar with abundance of good. Abundance of good. قال الشيخ ربيع حفظه الله تعالى والخير الكثير يدخل فيه النهر العظيم الذي يمد الحوض يغط منه ميزابان يمدان الحوض الذي من شرب منه لا يظمأ أبدا. اللهم اجعلني وإياكم منهم. آمين. Shaykh Rabi Hawatala, he says, and this abundance of good, na'am, from it is this river, this great river, that supplies the Hawd. This great river Al-Kawthar, that supplies the Hawd. From two streams, that supplies the Hawd. This Hawd, anyone who drinks from it, he will never go thirsty after that. May Allah make us from the Ameen. ثم قال الشيخ ربيع حفظه الله ويختلف أهل السنة في ترتيب الحوض والشفاعة والصراط أيها أول. Then the Sheikh mentioned a matter of اختلاف. He says أهل السنة they differ among themselves as related to which took place before the other, the order. Okay, the chronicle order, which one take first before or after the other, the Hawd, the Shafa'a, and Sirat. Which one comes first? Which one take place first? Is it the Hawd, Shafa'a, or the Sirat? قال فالبخاري رحمه الله كما يقول الحافظ يشير في ترتيبه أن الحوض بعد الصراط وبعد الحساب وبعد هذه الأشياء. So he says, as for Imam al-Bukhari, alam min a'lami sunnah. And Imam al-Bukhari is one of the great scholars of the Salaf. As al-Hafid, Ibn Hajar, he mentioned that in the order that Imam al-Bukhari gave, that the Hawd is after the Sirat. Okay, after the Sirat and after the reckoning, the Hisab, and after all of these things that take place. So it is after the Sirat. ويخالف الكثير بأن الحوض هو أول، يعني قبل الصراط وقبل الحساب وقبل الميزان وقبل هذه الأشياء. قال لأن الناس يخرجون عطاشا، يبعثهم الله عز وجل وهم عطاش، كما جاء في الحديث الصحيح. He says, but many others, مهل السنة, they disagree with Imam al-Bukhari, رحمه الله ورحم الله الجميع, and they say actually that the Hawd is the first thing. The Hawd is the first thing. Before the Sirat, before the accounting and the reckoning and the like, before everything else, before the Mizan, before the balance and the weighing of the deeds and the like. He says, because the people, they will be resurrected thirsty. Aynam, thirsty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect them thirsty, as he occurs in the hadith. And he mentioned the hadith that in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, the long hadith is a portion of that long hadith of the Shafa'ah. Remember in the Shafa'ah, the long hadith of the mention of the Adam and the prophets and the people turned to the people in Yawm al-Qiyamah, because of the terror of that day and the hardship of that day, they go to Adam to intercede on their behalf so that Allah established the accounting and the hisab. But Adam sent them to Nuh, and Nuh alayhi salam sent them to Ibrahim. Ibrahim sent them to Musa. Musa sent them to Isa. Isa sent them to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam go and prostrate, and then he praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the like. So the end of the hadith. A portion of the hadith that is collected by Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Muslim, on the authority of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu. What's his name, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri? You have your notes with you from Sunday class? Because we mentioned him. Because he was the one who narrated the hadith we study from the 40 hadith. Remember the hadith on Sunday? Abu Sa'id You got your notes with you, Zayd? You have different notebooks for different subjects? Jazakallah khair. Tayyib. All right, you think about it, inshallah. I won't give it to you, inshallah. Tayyib. Huh? Muhammad, he didn't write it? Luqman. نعم حسين سعد بن سنان مالك بن سنان مالك بن سعد بن سنان أين you were close الحمد لله طيب in the hadith that is narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله عنه it's good to know Abu Sa'id al-Khudri what if they mention his name sometimes you're like oh, is this a companion Like Abu Huraira, what's his name? Huh? Abdul Rahman ibn Auf? Huh? Abdul Rahman ibn Sakhar al-Iraqi? Huh? What is it? Because sometimes you have Abdul Rahman, but so many Abdul Rahman. Abdul Rahman ibn Sakhar al-Dawsi. Hey, no, Abu Huraira. What if a person said to you, Ya akhi, hunaka hadith. في الصحيحين because we are telling you because there is a hadith in Bukhari and Muslim who narrated it? عبد الرحمن بن صخر الدوسي I don't know this man you don't know him? Never heard of Abu Huraira? Well, I know Abu Huraira well, that's him سبحان الله Like, I give you tarifa in the hadith. I forget the names of the mashayikh, great mashayikh from the Salaf of hadith. And one of them, they were in this gathering, this majlis, in front of the Amir. They were discussing the hadith. And then one of them mentioned the hadith. And the other person says, no, I heard this hadith. And that person says, I'm the only one that heard it from that sheikh. All right? And then another person says, no. I heard it from another person who says that another person heard it from the sheikh. He said, who is he? He says, this and this and this, so-and-so. So he smiled. He said, why you smile? He said, that so-and-so is me. He said, that so-and-so is me, he says. You know? Inshallah. Aina am barakallahu fikum. He said, that's so-and-so that you, that person tell you, that's me, that's my name, that's my kunya, that's my name. Yeah, subhanAllah. Aina. So it's good to know the names. Give you an example. Me, Abu Muhammad al-Maghribi. Who knows my name? Abu Muhammad, that's not my name. How many people know my name here? Couple, huh? What's my name here? Maghribi, you see, that's not my name. That's not my name. That's not my name. Yes, subhanAllah, you don't know my name. Been with you for a while. Nobody asked me my name. I feel bad now. Huh? You know my name, Sajid? I know your name, why you don't know mine? Okay, sir, you know my name? Zaid, I thought you are my friends. My name is Ridwan. Ridwan ibn Idris. Aina. So remember that. So sometimes you may hear Ridwan ibn Idris. We don't know this brother. Who is he? You see? Aina. Barakallahu feekum. Think la'allahu waqt al-adhan, inshallah.
Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
هذا الحديث الصحيح فيه يدعى اليهود فيقال لهم ما كنتم تعبدون. In this hadith, a portion of it is a long hadith that the Jews will be called on يوم القيامة and they will be asked, what were you worshipping? قالوا كنا نعبد عزير ابن الله. They said we used to worship عزير, the son of Allah. فيقال كذبتم ما اتخذ الله من صاحبة ولا ولد فما تبغون فماذا تبغون. So it will be said to them, you lied. Allah did not have a wife nor a son. Allah did not take a wife, nor did he have a son, beget a son. What do you want? قَالُوا عَطِشْنَا يَا رَبَّنَا فَاسْقِنَا. They say, our Lord, we're thirsty. Give us something to drink. فَيُشَارُ إِلَيْهِمْ أَلَا تَرِدُونَ. Then he will be said to them, don't you go over there and drink? فَيُحْشَرُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ كَأَنَّهَا سَرَابٌ يُحَطِّمُ بَعْضُهَا بَعْضًا فَيَتَسَاقَطُونَ فِي النَّارِ. So they will be driven to the hellfire. They will be driven to the hellfire. Because the extreme heat of it, it looks to them as a mirage. It's like water. You know, the mirage in a hot day looks like it's water. And they will be cast in the hellfire. ثُمَّ تُدْعَى النَّصَارَى. Then the Christians will be brought and will be called. فَيُقَالُ لَهُمْ. And it will be said to them, مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْبُدُونَ. What you used to worship? قَالُوا كُنَّا نَعْبُدُ الْمَسِيحَ بْنُ اللَّهِ. And they will say on Yawm al-Qiyamah, they used to worship al-Masih, the son of Allah. فَيُقَالُ لَهُمْ كَذَبْتُمْ مَتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ مِنْ صَاحِبَةٍ وَلَا وَلَدَ فَمَاذَا تَبْغُونَ. Then it will be said to them, you have lied. Allah does not have a wife nor a son. What do you want? فَيَقُولُونَ عَطِشْنَا يَا رَبَّنَا فَاسْقِنَا. They say, we are thirsty, O our Lord. Give us to drink. فَيُشَارُ إِلَيْهِمْ أَلَا تَرِدُونَ. Then he will say, don't you go there and drink? فَيُحْشَرُونَ إِلَى جَهَنَّمْ كَأَنَّهَا سَرَابٌ. So they will be driven to the hellfire. It looks to them like a mirage. يُحَطِّمُ بَعْدُهَا بَعْدًا. A part of it destroying the other part. نسأل الله السلام والعافية. فَيَتَسَاقَطُونَ فِي النَّارِ. So they will fall into the hellfire. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. قَالْ أَمَّا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ فَيَسْقِيهِمُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مِنَ الْحَوْضِ. That as for the believers, they will be given to drink from the hawd. Naam Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them to drink from the hawd. Qala Shaykh Rabi' Habibullah, wa tadhkuru ba'd al-ahadith anna li kulli nabiyyin hawdan wa hawd nabiyyina a'zamuha wa yamtazu 'alayha bi annahu yumaddu min al-kawthar. So there is some narrations that mention that every prophet has a pool, has a hawd. But the hawd of our Prophet is the greatest of all and is better because it is supplied by the Kawthar. It is supplied by the Kawthar. We continue, inshallah ta'ala, still in this chapter in the next class, inshallah. هذا وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا.